There are a number of small and short-legged dogs, but few are truly dwarf breeds. While many breeds can suffer from abnormal dwarfism, there are certain breeds that were created to be short-legged in order to better do their jobs. There are also various types of dwarfism, and here we'll focus on the dog breeds that have what's called micrometric achondroplasia, meaning they have short legs but are standard-sized elsewhere. Number 10, Pug. The adorable pug has shortened legs and a shortened muzzle because the breed has two types of dwarfism. The breed originates from China and was brought to Europe in the 16th and 17th centuries, where it was loved and adored. Pugs need constant human companionship. If you own a pug, expect him to follow you around in the house, sit in your lap, and want to sleep in bed with you. Number 9, Dachshund. This German breed was originally bred to scent and flush out badgers, and their short legs were required for them to crawl into dens. All variations of the Dachshund are achondroplastic. Dachshunds are intelligent dogs with an independent nature and playful spirit. Because of this, they can be mischievous. Be patient, firm, and consistent when training them. Number 8, Pembroke Welsh Corgi. The Pembroke Welsh Corgi originated as a cattle herder, and its short legs prevented it from getting kicked. The breed is rarely used in farm work today, but can still be found herding sheep, cattle, and other livestock throughout the world in sport. Even though they are small dogs, Pembrokes have a lot of energy and need a healthy amount of exercise each day. Pembrokes are prone to overeating. Their food intake should be monitored closely. Number 7, Cardigan Welsh Corgi. The Cardigan Welsh Corgi is the older of the Corgi breeds and was also bred as a cattle herding dog. Just like its Pembroke cousin, its short legs kept it from getting kicked during work. Cardigans have a strong herding instinct that may cause them to nip at the heels of your children when they are playing. Cardigans are intelligent but can be stubborn. If house training is a problem, crate training is advised. Number 6, English Bulldog. The English Bulldog, although relatively large, is a true dwarf breed with legs that grow abnormally compared to other standard-sized dogs. This gives the breed its frog-like hindquarters and shortened muzzle. Bulldogs can be stubborn and lazy. Your mature Bulldog may not be very enthusiastic about going to a walk, but it's important that he is exercised every day to keep him fit. Number 5, French Bulldog. The French Bulldog is a dwarf breed just like his English cousin, as he also gets his shorter legs and muzzle from achondroplasia. The breed originated from crossbreeding between Bulldog types with French rat hunting dogs. French Bulldogs can be a quiet breed and are not known as a breed that barks frequently, although there are exceptions to every rule. They can be easy to train, but they can also be stubborn. Be firm and patient when training this breed. Number 4, Basset Hound. The Basset Hound is a scent hound that is considered the dwarfed version of a bloodhound. It's a French breed, with the name Basset coming from the French word bass, meaning low. With two-thirds of their body weight in the front of their bodies, Basset Hounds are not great swimmers. Don't allow your Basset Hound to fall into a swimming pool, because he can quickly get into trouble. Number 3, Dandie Dinmont Terrier. This unique terrier comes from Scotland, where it was used to hunt badgers and others. It now makes both an excellent watchdog and family companion, as it is tough but friendly. Their bark is surprisingly loud and deep, but being a typically reserved breed, they can be trained to be quiet on command. Because they are terriers, they are prone to chasing rabbits, birds, and even other dogs and cats. Number 2, Skye Terrier. The Skye Terrier is also from Scotland, on the Isle of Skye. They were originally bred to hunt otters and foxes among rocky terrain. Its beautiful, long coat has been loved and appreciated since the 16th century, according to early documentation. Skye Terriers are best suited to homes with older children who understand how to interact with dogs. Although the Skye Terrier has a moderate activity level and is quiet indoors, he still requires daily exercise. Expect at least 30 minutes of exercise each day. Number 1, Scottish Terrier. Although the Scottish Terrier became popular in the United States due to its multiple president owners, the breed comes from Scotland, where it was used to hunt vermin on farms as well as foxes and otters. Although Scottish Terriers enjoy exercise, they are not recommended as jogging companions. With his short legs, a short walk around your block can feel like a long-distance marathon to the Scottish Terrier. Behind German Shepherds and Rottweilers, Scotties have been ranked third in alarm barking. They will bark at strangers and are not the ideal pet in a dwelling or area that has noise rules. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. Which is your favorite dwarf dog breed? Let us know in the comments. Here are some other cool videos I know you'll enjoy. See you guys later.